there's quite a lot to surveying Orange Roughy.
There's a big area, so you need to search, you need to fish, you need to, yeah, be patient and just keep searching.
Down over!
NIWA has always been quite involved into deep water research for fisheries and precursor in using deep towed acoustic systems on Orange Roughy and on other species. So we've got the expertise and we've got systems that we've developed in-house that work really, really well. During the spawning period, Orange Roughy will aggregate into quite tight schools, and so that makes it quite a good time to survey them.
Although most fish have swim bladders filled with air, Orange Roughy have the swim bladder filled with wax esters, so that makes them weak acoustic targets.
So we have to deploy an instrument down to 500 meters below the surface and about 300 meters above the fish to see those fish.
And that's when we use our tow systems, so we get the differences between the frequencies that we need to separate Orange Roughy from other species.
Gonna hit the water in about now. Yeah, we're in the water, it's all yours.
Once it's touched the water, we're just gonna pay out wire slowly to stretch its target depth, which is around 500 meters in our case.
Yeah, I presume they're gonna turn a little bit and follow this.
We're gonna use this toasty to create a grid above the aggregation. So basically it's a picture of the aggregation at a given time. And we're going to use this picture to estimate the abundance of Orange Roughy. Those snapshots, they usually take from 6 to 12 hours. So it's a really long exposure. So it's not a simple process, which is also why answers that you can get from several snapshots on the same aggregation are going to be quite variable, which is why we need repeated measurements to average them and to get a more precise answer.
We're recording on different frequencies, and the difference between the two can tell us whether the fish is a swim bladder species or not. If a fish has got a big swim bladder, it reflects off more sound than fish that don't have swim bladders. So we really want to find the roughy aggregated in a single species, hopefully a little bit off the bottom, so that we can measure how many are in that school.
Every acoustic measurements have to be ground truth using a sampling method. In our case, we need to troll on those aggregations. Those trolls are going to give us two things. They're going to give us confirmation that what we believe we're seeing is what we see. And then it's also going to give us biological parameters that are needed for two things. They are needed to feed into stock assessment models, and they're also needed to get a better estimation of the acoustic properties of the aggregation.
It was a very successful shot. We got about 2 tons of Orange Roughy, most of it running ripe. There's females and males that indicates that spawning is actively happening right now. So it's a very good shot because it's clean and it's sufficient to show that the species that we're after was the one that's providing giving the acoustic energy that we're measuring.
We're doing the work, not only the survey work, but we're also doing all the analysis of the data later on, turn it into a meaningful number and produce a report that's going to be given to the Ministry of Primary Industry and Fisheries New Zealand. That's where the decision-making process starts. If there is a recovery of the stock, we need to understand it. If it doesn't get better, we also need to understand it. So that's where we need to do regular and decent surveys to set reasonable quotas for the harvest.